Okay, so we will continue our chapter 9 on resort operation with the type of resort operation. Okay, so there are two main operations in a resort. So I have teach you on the chapter 1 before. There are front office and also back office. Okay, so what is front office and what is the back office? Okay, so if the things called front office, then it's include firstly front desk. So when you come to the hotel, if you see the front desk, then yes, that is the front office. Okay, uniform service mean the people who keep the safety of the resort or hotel. For example, police guard. Okay, they're using uniform. Okay, uniform. Okay, so concierge. Okay, concierge is the one such as bellboy, someone who become the valet, they manage the valet parking, the one who pick up the luggage. So that is concierge. Okay, and lastly is front office accounting system, the one who responsible for all the money and all the paywave, all the credit card and debit card, the one who do the cashier. Yes, that is front office accounting system. Okay, so following are the basic responsible for front office. Okay, so they operating and this is their responsible. Okay, creating a guest database, because when the guests come and they will collect the database. For example, how many day to stay, how much the room is, what size of the room, one do they want extra package, do they want food, something like that. So that's the guest database. Okay, handling guest account, the payment. Okay, coordinating the guest service, they give the service to the guest, stay smile and show them, okay, how, where is the your room, where is the amenities, where is the swimming pool. That is coordinating guest service, trying to sell a service. Maybe the guests come only to relax, but actually the hotel have spa, so they recommend the guests to take the spa package. So that is sell a service. Okay, and lastly is ensuring guest satisfaction. Easy. Okay, right, ensuring the guest satisfaction. Okay, so how about the back office? Okay, back office of hotel or resort are the area that are almost inaccessible to the customer. Okay, and do not directly affect hotel revenue. Okay, so back, they are known as back office because first, they are not facing the customer. Second, the place where they're working are totally secret and also inaccessible to the customer. Okay, so back office is the backbone of the hotel. So if the front office is the face of the hotel itself, so they are the one who support the management. That is backbone. Okay, so of the hotel is the main foundation in order for the hotel to operate smoothly. Okay, because they are the one who control the finance, they are the one who control the people who work for the hotel, human resource, they are the one who control the safety and also maintain the room, the cleanliness of the room. They are the one who do all the thing. Okay, so for example, the example of back office department is accounting department, okay, human resource department, technical and maintenance department, and also food and beverages. Okay, because food and beverages maybe kitchen, you can the customer cannot enter. Okay, so third is retail. Okay, so we will talk about some of the hotel have their own retail. Okay, for example, this is Mandarin Oriental KL. So they have their own retail. So this is where they sell their own product, the hotel product. Okay, because they want to get more revenue. Okay, so retail sales are significant part of most of resort operation. Okay, because the resort itself sometimes have their own specialty. For example, the nature itself. So the customer want to bring back the nature to their hometown as souvenir, something like that. So that is the responsible or role of the retail shop itself in the resort. Okay, so merchandise sale account for 30% of total revenue for resort golf facilities in United States. For example, this is example at the golf resort. Because of golf resort, people never bring their own ball, never bring their own maybe golf club. Okay, that why they buy from this retail shop. Okay, because it's quite heavy to bring. Maybe they just want, because they are luxury people, then instead of bringing it from their home, they just buy the things at the retail shop. Okay, so what is the characteristic of the retail product that can be sell in the resort? So product uniqueness, okay, how scarce and how unique it's to a particular destination. Okay, for example, if you go to resort in Malaysia, then some of the resort sell songket, something like that, because you can't find this kind of songket in other places. Okay, so if you come to resort in Indonesia, maybe their resort selling batik, because you can find batik, and only batik Jawa is unique for Indonesian. Okay, so they want something that original. Okay, that why if you want to sell something in the resort that known as retail product, then you must know the product uniqueness itself. Okay, so cultural and historical integrity. This is a very easy product that want to sell, that will have, that you will sell. Okay, for example, the cultural product and also the historical product. Just like I said before, batik, songket, something like that. Okay, aesthetic. Is it visual appealing? Okay, so people only want to buy something that beautiful. Okay, people do not want to buy something that not quality and also not beautiful. So you have to ensure that the product that you sell is pleasing, aesthetic. Okay, and lastly is workmanship. The more handmade the thing is, the more valuable, the more pricey of the product itself. Okay, that why you have to, if you want to sell something in resort, make sure the product that you sell have all four characteristics. Okay, and this is type of the retail product that maybe you have been experienced in a resort. For example, pictorial image, okay, postcard, book, poster, okay, piece of rock. Okay, maybe if you go to Guam Ulu and there are resort that near Guam Ulu, maybe they sell the rock of Guam Ulu, something like that. Okay, if you go to beach resort, maybe they are selling the coral that die, maybe they sell the shell, something like that. Okay, symbolic shorthand, maybe replica of famous attraction. Okay, maybe if you go to resort in KL, they give you KLCC small tower, something like that. They sell, it's not give. Okay, marker, item that mark with word, logos, and coffee mark and shot glass. Okay, maybe also a shirt, something like that, something that have marks, have brand. Okay, and lastly is a local product, batik, food and drink. If you go to Malaysia, of course people will buy the Musang King, maybe Musang King Suite, something like that. Okay, and last but not least is eco launch. This is something that new, recently popular trend in resort. How you want to operate resort in more responsible way? Eco launch is the answer. Okay, so what is eco launch actually? So eco launch is a specialized form of resort. Okay, not all resort is known as eco launch. It is special kind of resort. So an ecology or nature based resort launch is defined as a nature dependent tourist launch that meet the philosophy and principle of ecotourism. Okay, so first and foremost, it must be sustainable. Second, it must respect the nature. And lastly, people want to get near toward the nature itself. Okay, that why they built the eco launch. Maybe this eco launch, instead of using aircon, they're using the fan, something like that. Okay, so it's very near to nature. Okay, so eco launch are designed using natural sustainable material that are collected on the site. So we are not using something that concrete. Okay, because if you use something that concrete, it will slowly destroy the place itself. For example, the transportation of the concrete. And if you build the concrete, then you have to get some lorry to get inside the jungle, then it will destroy the small plant, right? So you use the material that available in the forest itself. Okay, so objective for eco launch to generate their own energy from renewable resource and manage their own waste. Okay, so So we want to, they use their own renewable sources. Maybe they use wheel, the water wheel, something like that. Okay, so this is the difference between eco-lounge and also traditional kind of resort. Okay, so first is luxury. Maybe eco-lounge is not really luxury, but comfortable and fulfill the basic necessity of a people. Okay, generic style mean a typical kind of resort, luxury, something like that. Okay, unique characteristic style, because we are putting a nature kind of style. Okay, relaxation focus, eco-lounge activity and educational focus. Okay, facility based activity, nature recreation based activity. Okay, enclave development. Enclave mean the development will cause around surrounding place also develop. For example, if you build the resort near the Kuching waterfront, of course people will come to your resort and it will cause the development of the place near your resort. But eco-lounge, we want to protect the surrounding environment, because our surrounding development is the local environment itself. Okay, so we don't want to destroy. So that is known as development integrated with local environment. We don't want to enclave development. Okay, group or consortium ownership common. So because it will maybe owned by corporations, something like that, such as Hilton, Hilton is easy example. Individual ownership common, because it's something that so special, so not everyone want to invest their money for something like that. Okay, and it also very risky, because not everyone will come to the jungle and willingly to have a resort in the jungle. Okay, so I think the others you can read by yourself. Okay, so I think that's all from me. If you have any question, then you can just text me or you can just email me. Okay, so thank you so much and happy fasting.